Take a look around you, even in your own pocket. We are surrounded by technologies that were considered science fiction only a few years ago. 7 years ago, we have created a team to see if we can explore the world of medical holography and take it into reality. At the time, this was something considered totally science fiction. In fact, when we talked to experts at the time, the general response was, it can't be done, and followed by very knowledgeable explanations and scientific explanations. Since then, we've proven not only that it can be done, but that it can also provide significant value to physicians and can potentially improve healthcare. Going back in time, the first X-ray image was generated back in 1895. This is actually the first time that the inner parts of the body were imaged, were seen without having to cut it open. This very famous image was created by Professor William Röntgen, an image of his wife with a finger, totally science fiction. If you move forward in time, then 20, 30 years ago, seeing 3D images was considered in medical imaging was considered also science fiction. This is an example of a 3D dynamic, real-time 3D image of a mitral valve, one of the valves in the heart, generated by 3D ultrasound. And we were seeing physicians looking at this image, and we were thinking, why are physicians seeing a 3D spatial image confined inside a 2D screen? And this sparked our imagination and took us on this very fascinating journey into the world of medical holography. Now, when you think about 3D, you typically think about goofy glasses that you put on in a theater, and then you have an illusion of an image that is floating in front of you. But if you want to have a real image and not an illusion, then you need to use the technology called holography. Now, holography is a magical thing. It was invented back in the 60s by Dr. Denis Gabor, which also received the Nobel Prize for this invention back in 1971. The problem is that all the holograms that were created since the 60s are static holograms, like viewing a 3D picture. I remember myself 7 years ago in a science museum in Tel Aviv, looking at a hologram of a person looking at me, floating in the air, quite amazed by the fact that I can see it just in front of me, and trying to think, what would be the impact if this person would come to life, if we could do this dynamic and digital? So there are great challenges in creating a video of a hologram, and this is the challenges that we've overcome over the past few years. And these challenges range from very heavy computation all the way to creating a high-quality image that can be useful for physicians. Once you manage to overcome these limitations, then you can, this is an illustration of what we could do. We could now have the image floating in front of the physician so he can really understand the organ in front of him and really see it floating in the air very clearly. And we could do that with any imaging modality based on CT or 3D ultrasound or MRI. Now, this is a really cool technology. I hope you would agree, but many of you might be asking yourself, why do I need it? Why would the physician want to use a hologram in his procedures? So there are two great things about a hologram. One is the fact that it's the most intuitive visualization there is. So it's very natural to see a hologram. You see it floating in front of you. You can move your head in front of you. It's really there, just like I'm holding my hand here in front of me. But we didn't just want to have the holograms, to see the holograms. We also wanted for these holograms to be interactive. So the second great thing about a hologram is that once you have a hologram in a precise location, you can now manipulate the hologram in the air. You can move the hologram in front of you. You can go in with a tool and measure something. And measurement is something very common in medicine. So now you don't have to do it on 2D. You can do it on the real 3D object much more accurately. You can take an actual device, like a stent or a valve, put it inside the image and see if it fits this specific patient. And you can also crop the hologram to a specific 2D plane and extract this 2D plane from the hologram so you know exactly where you are or where this 2D plane is coming from as a physician. The first clinical environment that we worked in is the cardiac cath lab, and the concept in the cardiac cath lab was to take the image, to have it hovering above the patient, and to have the physician be able to manipulate this image in the air in front of him. About a year ago, we've conducted our first clinical trials, the first time that holograms were generated in a real environment in real time. This was created by an amazing team from Schneider Children's Medical Center, from Philips Healthcare, and from my company, RealView Imaging. I can tell you that for me personally, this was a very, very moving experience. It's the first time after working for many years and developing the technology from scratch that there is a patient on the table and his heart is being imaged and you can see this heart floating in the air. It's an amazing, amazing experience. We've used a number of modalities to acquire the image. We used 3D ultrasound and X-ray, and all this information was streamed into our system in real time, creating these holograms. One of the first cases that we did was a 21-year-old patient with a hole in the heart, a condition known as ASD, atrial septum defect. And what you're seeing here is the first ever hologram of a heart floating in the air of a patient in real time. You can see that the physician is actually putting his finger inside the hologram. You can see that it's just in front of him very clearly. He can manipulate it, he can move it, he can crop it to the right location, and he wants to understand the anatomy before he does the procedure and closes this hole percutaneously. So here's an example of how you crop it, and then you can move it around and really see the anatomy like it's never been done before. Another nice case that we did was a 2-year-old patient. This is an image acquired from 3D X-ray. So this information, again, streamed to our system, floating in there. You can see, without going into the clinical details, you can see this vascular structure clearly in the air. The physician can visualize it very clearly, but he can also manipulate it and mark things and do whatever you like, he likes, in this hologram. We've spent a number of weeks at the hospital doing those trials. I think the reaction of the physicians was truly amazing, and there was a genuine interest in working with holograms and see this, where this can take us. Over this period of time, the most important thing for us was to learn, to have discussions with the physicians, and to understand what is the clinical benefits in the interventional environment. And these benefits can range from shorter procedures, less radiation during the procedures, and at the end of the day, better imaging in medicine provides better clinical results. I have 3 children, and this is a picture of my twins taken 3 years ago, 18 weeks into their pregnancy. They look much better now. And this is another area that we're looking at, so we can now take such images and present them as holograms floating in the air. So a mother and a father can now hold their baby in their hand before it's born as a hologram very clearly and do all these manipulations. It has a great emotional value, but more than that, it has also some clinical values that have to do with better measurements and possibly identification of some specific birth defects. So naturally, I spend a lot of time in hospitals, and in a hospital, I like to look at the building from the outside and try to imagine in the different departments, where could holography make a difference? Where would people want to use holograms? And I can definitely envision that in the hospital of the future, holography, medical holography, will be used across many, many departments for various procedures, both for diagnostics, for interventional procedures, but also for communication between physicians and communication between physicians and patients. So taking science fiction to life is a great journey. This journey, I'm doing it together with an amazing group of very passionate people to create this. And it's I hope that very soon you will see this technology in practice and we'll make our little contribution to the world of medical imaging. Thank you very much.